Next, a DC group offering up their take on a 60s classic made famous by a son of their city, Marvin Gaye. Performing the Motown hit, I Heard It Through the Grapevine, here is Afro-Blue.
Much longer would you be mine? You know that I heard through the grapevine, and you know I'm just about to lose my mind. Honey, honey, yeah, yeah. Don't you know I heard it through the grapevine, that not much longer would you be mine? You know that I heard, oh yeah, and you know I'm just about to lose. About you, yeah. Oh,
everybody was talking about you.
Everybody was talking about you. Afro-Blue, man. Let's go ahead and go to the panel, Ben.
Trent, you looked really mean at the end. You almost held being mean for a second. You're like, the arrangement definitely picked some fights. So you were going for some stuff that I thought was working brilliantly. Other times, you were going over our heads. About the time you hit that first modulation, you changed groove and everything, too. So it was like, wow, I just thought I put a bag over my head and went through a car wash backwards for a second. I think what that was something we used to do back in the 60s.
Keep it with the theme.
Yeah, that's right. It's a 60s thing. It was soulful. It was executed really, really well. You're just state of the art. You know, you're a great group. I just think you overthought it a little bit too much. But you're amazing, and we all know that. So nice effort.
Sean?
Marvin, which is one of my favorite singers, he always had a knack for taking care of the solo. Being able to sing sweet and smooth, yet masculine. Trent, you grabbed that, especially in the beginning. You massaged the first verse. And the modulation that you guys did was effortless. That was amazing how you went into that. It went from key to key. That was amazing. Good job.
Sarah, thoughts?
One of the things I love the best about you guys, obviously you're all masterminds musically, but you're so committed to whatever choices you're making as a unit, and it's a pleasure to watch. Brian and Reggie, dude, your bass, amazing. That was amazing. Trent, what a sweet, soulful voice you have, and that big smile. Oh man, you are just a charmer. I loved it when it went to the halftime groove, and I thought, again, Brian on vocal percussion, that was sick as well. But then I kind of wanted to hear it return back to the 60s, bookended it a little bit, but really well done. Good job, guys.
All right, thank you, judges. Thank you, Afro-Blue. We'll find out later if Afro-Blue made it to the next round.